Hi friends, so welcome to lesson 12. So we made it to almost the end of the chapter 7, coordinate geometry. So far we have covered 7.1 until 7.10, and today we're gonna cover all 7.1 until 7.10, and we compile into questions, a bigger questions. It's gonna be a little bit tough, but it's okay, we're gonna learn this, okay? And the thing that I want to show you today is the working. Okay, we need to learn how to write a proper working, because it involves a lot of coordinates, a lot of equations, you see, so a lot of numbers. All right, so we need to write down in a proper way where the examiner or me can see clearer. Okay, but before that, let's check out our previous lessons work first. All right, let's go. So this is Jasmine's from year 9 science 1 work. Okay, let's check her work together, okay? And for your case, also the same. Please double check and compare your answer with mine, with Jasmine's one, alright? So, 7.10, there's a little bit of mistake here, Jasmine. And the rest of you, please double check, especially your formula, right? Okay, so what have you noticed about the formula, everyone? You can check this out again, if just to recall back, okay? Recall back again your area of the polygon or area of a triangle. The mistake here is, here over here, it's supposed to be a minus, okay? It's supposed to be a minus. Alright, let's check this quadrilateral as well. This quadrilateral also, same, okay? This one's supposed to be a minus, okay? Just a minor mistake here. Please check. Oh, it's not a minor, it's quite a major, because if you're following this formula, then it's wrong, right? But when I check your example and exercise, it's all correct. So, yeah, no problem. Example 23, please take note on this one. This answer, example 23, please double check again. Yes, this is the answer. But this one, please change it to minus. It's not a plus. Please change it. Okay, and example 24 here, okay, it's a minus here or correct, okay, 55.5, okay, example 24. Yo, please double check also, Okay, number 1A, this one correct, 16.5 correct, working also correct, and then 29 units, and then 27.5 units. Most of your work here are all correct for all of you, okay, so well done on this topic, this subtopic, 30.5, and then this one is 38.5 units, and then 25 units. Okay, please double check your work. All right, today's lesson, as I say, we're gonna do a bigger questions. All right, and this lesson I want to teach you how to write in a proper working, okay, write in a proper way where you yourself, me, or examiner can see your working clear. Okay, because if I don't teach you, you will write down everywhere you want, and then your coordinate, your gradient, or your equations are all jumbled up. Okay, I don't know which equation you are. You need to mention all that, right? Okay, so before that, of course, you need to copy this question. This is from page 173 textbook. All right, you copy this question first, and then you pause this video. You copy the question. Please. Look at the question, read the questions first, okay? Then after that, you continue with my lesson, okay? You don't do it by yourself first, okay? Because I want you to write down in a proper way, okay? If you try it by your own, please, after you check your working with my working, you improvise your working, okay? Change it or edit it to the way that examiner or me can see, okay? So you pause the video first. Copy the question and read the question, read through the questions, okay? Okay, so now I assume you already read the questions already and copy down the questions. Okay, so now I'm gonna lead you and teach you how to do these questions, okay? Alright, so I believe you already read the questions. So here it says that it's an isosceles triangle here, ABC, which AB equals to AC, okay? It's already stated in the diagram. The coordinate 5, 6 and 0, negative 4 is your AB, okay? Given that the gradient of BC is 3 over 4, okay? So I'm gonna write down here, the gradient of BC. When you write gradient, you don't just write M, okay? Because M is everywhere. You have to write M with the BC there to tell me or tell yourself that this M, this gradient is for the BC. So M, gradient BC is 3 over 4. Okay, don't just write M equals to 3 over 4, because this M, I don't know which M you are mentioning about. Okay, so many lines here. So you need to mention, you need to write down M, BC. Okay? And that the perpendicular from A to BC meets BC at D. Okay, it's also on the diagram already here. It's already mentioned there. Find the equation of BC and of AD. Okay, now. So part A. Here you see the question here. It says part A, have to find two equations of BC and AD. If you write y equals mx plus c, and the other one also y equals mx plus c, how do I know which one equation BC, which one equation AD, right? So you need to write down in a way where I understand, and you also understand, and I can see it easily. You can see your working easily, okay? So you're going to write down equation of BC. Okay, just write EQ, equation of BC. So we're going to find this equation of BC. Okay, so equation of BC here. Okay, equation of BC is this line over here. Okay, we have our gradient already, and we have our C. Okay, or this line passing through 0, negative 4, you can sub in this one to find your C, but anyway, that is already your C. Your point B is already your C. Your y-intercept is your negative 4 already. So your equation will be y equals to 3 over 4x minus 4. Okay? So this is your working. Okay, and then you highlight your answer to show me that this is equation of BC. You see this? I write this one down. Equation of BC. Okay, I show to you that this is equation of BC. Okay? And then next question, also in part A, equation of AD. Okay, so now you're going to find equation of AD. Okay, so equation of AD here is... Zoom in, this one. We know that this is a perpendicular. You see that it's a perpendicular. So meaning to say that if perpendicular means your gradient will be reciprocal negative reciprocal, okay? So the gradient over here, which is your MAD, gradient of AD is negative reciprocal. So you, this 3 over 4, you flip it and you add a negative. So it's negative 3 over 4, okay? So you see, when I write this one down, right, I write MAD, means that this gradient is meant for your AD. And this gradient of BC, MBC, is the M is for your BC line. Okay, if you write both also M, I cannot see, I don't know which one is your M. I don't know that M is for who, for which line. Okay, so when you find equation of AD, your gradient of AD equals to negative 4 over 3. Okay, if you don't want to write too near, it's okay, write it at the side here. Okay, so gradient of AD is negative 4 over 3. So now we want to find y equals mx plus c. Remember, when you need to find equation of AD, or equation in general, you need to find y equals mx plus c, right? So we already have our gradient, y equals to negative 4 over 3x plus c. So now we want to find c. The thing here is, you don't simply sub in any points that you see from the question. You see 0, negative 4, you sub in. You see 5, 6, you sub in. Not knowing that which equation you're actually finding, you don't simply sub in any points that you like. Okay? So we are finding this equation, right? This equation. This equation passing through what? Passing through 5, 6. As it's not passing through 0, negative 4. You see the line doesn't pass through 0, negative 4. You don't sub in 0, negative 4. Wrong. So you sub in 5, 6, your point A, because this equation is passing through this point of 5, 6. So I sub in this one. And my C is 38 over 3. So my equation is y equals to negative 4 over 3x plus 38 over 3. So this is for my equation of AD. Okay, you see I'm showing this part here, the equation is for my AD. If you just write this one and this one without mentioning this equation, which equation? So I don't know which equation are you mentioning. Okay, so you must write it down something like this or something that I can see. This one is stand for equation of AD. And the gradient that you are looking for, you are writing down is meant for which equation. Okay, right, so let's go to question part B. Part B is asking for coordinate of D. Okay, now let's look at coordinate D. Your coordinate of D is this one here. So to find coordinate of D, okay, you have to check first. Okay, this coordinate of D, is it a point of intersection? Because normally if they ask to find coordinate, normally it's either point of intersection or use midpoint formula or depend on the questions actually. But this one we can see that part A is telling us finding BC and AD, and which leads to part B finding D, which means that you need to find the simultaneous equation because D is your point of intersection. Okay, point of intersection between the line BC and AD. You see, they cross each other at D. So this is point of intersection coordinate D. Okay, so point of intersection, which is your D, is your XY. Okay, so a simultaneous equation between the two equations. Okay, understand this one? Okay, simultaneous. So after that, what I do is I move the negative 4 over 3 to the other side, become plus. And then I move the negative 4, become plus 4. Then this one is 25 over 12x equals to 50 over 3. So my x is 50 over 3 divided by 25 over 12, because this one I move, become divide. So x is equals to 8. And then I sub into either of the equation. Okay, equation BC also can, AD also can, because it's simultaneous equation, right? So you will still get the same answer either of the equation. So this one is 2. So therefore, your D is 8, 2. Okay, I highlight some more to show you that is my answer. Okay, so I'm looking for this. And this is my working C. Okay, look at part C. I'm going to write down here part C. The coordinate of C. Okay, let's look at coordinate of C here. Okay, it's a point of intersection between AC and BC. But we don't have the equation here. We don't have the equation here, so we cannot find that. We cannot find that. Okay, so we cannot use point of intersection. See what else do we have. Okay, this one we don't need anymore. We put it, we erase first. So how do we find C? Okay, we are given isosceles. Okay, this isosceles tells you something. Okay, it tells you that they have the same side. Okay, same distance. So when this one is 90 degrees perpendicular going down, meaning to say that this side and this side is also the same. Okay, these two sides are the same, which means that D is your midpoint. Okay, your D here is your midpoint of your BC. See, I read MP. Okay, so D is your midpoint of midpoint, and D we already found it earlier, right? Is 8, 2. So okay, I'm gonna write 8, 2 here. So now we can find our C lah, XY. Because D is midpoint, you already given midpoint here and one of the side, so you can find the other one here. Okay, you have a line. Okay, this is your B, 0, negative 4. This is your D, which is your midpoint, 8, 2. And this is your C, which is your XY. Okay, it's from here. Okay, I just draw it out to let you see. So this x plus this x divided by 2 equals to this 8. Okay, so 0 plus x over 2 is equals to 8. So your x is 16. Okay, and then negative 4, the y plus the other y divided by 2 is equals 2. So negative 4 plus y over 2 equals 2. And your y is 4 plus 4, which is 8. So your coordinate of C is 16, 8. See that? Okay, so this is your working for finding C. Now, part D, the length of the perpendicular AD. Okay, perpendicular AD. So you already have A, you already have your D, you can find the length. Okay, so you use the length formula length. For part D, formula length. So AD is equals to square root of 5 minus 8 square plus 6 minus 2 square. Okay, equals to square root 25. Double check my answer. So it's 5 units. Okay, and then part E. The area of triangle ABC. Okay. Triangle ABC. So C we already have just now. Okay, we found it already. C. Your C is 16, 8. And we have A, we have B. So we can use the formula of area of a triangle. Okay, we learned in our previous lesson part E. So this one we are finding area of triangle ABC. So it's equals to half. Okay, I put 0, negative 4 first. Normally my first point I will put something with the 0. Okay, so anti-clockwise 0, negative 4, 16, 8, and then 5, 6, go back to 0, negative 4. 16, 8, 5, 6, go back to 0, negative 4. It's much easier if you put the 0 when there is something 0 from the first vertex. Okay, so this one is like this, plus. Okay, so 0 I don't write, so I write first lah, just in case you forget. Plus 5 times negative 4. And then minus the other way round. Shoelace method, Okay, so it's 50 units square. That's for question 19. Okay, so you see how I organize my work properly. Let's go to question 20. Alright, so pause the video. You copy the question first. You read through the questions. Okay. Alright, so I assume you already copy your questions and already read through the questions. So I'm going to guide you how to write a proper working and how to do this kind of questions. Okay. So this question is a diagram where it's a shape of a trapezium. Angle BCD 90. Okay, it's already there. Point ABC is also already given. So here it's stated here. AB equals to 2BC. Okay, the length of the AB equals to 2 times the length of the BC. Okay, so here we have ABC. Okay, we cannot use a ratio formula because this is not a straight line. So to find our value of A, part A here is to find the value of A, right? So we have to use the length formula for AB equals to 2 times BC. Okay, so the length of AB using the formula, bracket A minus 12 bracket square plus 18 minus negative 2 become plus 2. Okay, equals to 2 times BC. The length of BC is also a square root of 12 minus 2 bracket square plus negative 2 minus negative 7 become plus 7. Okay, like that. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here is this one I don't want to expand. This one is 20 squared, so it's 400. The square root equals to 2 times this is a square root of 125. You try press calculator, manatau I careless mistake leh. Okay, so if you want to get rid of the square root, right? You cannot just get rid like that, square root and square root. I cannot, because there's a 2 here. So what I'm gonna do is I square left side and I square right side. Okay, so if I square left side, so the square root no more, or no more certs, and you square on your right side, these two become 4. I use this color now, 4 become 4. And then these certs 125 become 125 without the certs. Okay, so for here, what I do is I move my 400 to the other side. This one I move up, become minus. This one I get 500 minus 400, so it's 100. Okay, I'm not gonna expand this square here, because I would prefer to move my square to the other side, become square root. So it's plus minus 100, square root 100. So A equals to plus minus 10 plus 12. So I get two answers. One is 22, the other one is 2. Okay, one is 10 plus 12, the other one is negative 10 plus 12. So negative 10 plus 12 is 12, is 2. Okay, so which one I'm gonna reject? Because A is only one value, right? Okay, you look back at your diagram. 22 and 2, which one makes more sense? 2 you need to reject. Why? Because your 2 for the x, because this is for x, is already taken for C. Okay, it's already there. And then you look at this, B is already 12. So if you're on your right side, it will be 22 is most likely to be the answer. Okay, so we reject these two, so your A is 22. Okay, I highlight the answer now, 22. Okay, so this is my working for part A. And then my part B, find the equation of AD. Okay, so now I already have my A, which is my which is 22. Now I want to find equation of AD. So equation of AD is y equals to mx plus c for this. So to find equation, we need gradient and we need C. Okay, C is not given, gradient is not given, but look at the diagram and see what are we given. Okay, it's a parallel line. So this parallel line tells us something. Okay, it tells us that this gradient of BC is also the gradient of this AD or DA. Okay, then we can find our M. So before you find the equation of this AD, okay, so the working to find equation of AD will be here. So we find gradient first, because gradient of BC is equals to gradient of AD. Parallel. Yeah, because it's a parallel. That's why the gradient is the same. So my Y is equals to, before you find Y, you have to find gradient first. So find gradient of BC. So BC, you already have 2 points. Why we don't straight away find gradient of AD? Because we only have 1 point. We don't have D. We don't have any other point to find Y2 minus Y1 over X2 minus X1. Okay? So gradient of BC, Y2 minus Y1. Y2 minus negative 7 become plus 7 over 12 minus 2. So it's 5 over 10, which is 1 over 2. So my gradient is 1 over 2. This is my gradient of AD. They are the same, Same gradient. And then my C, Y equals to half X plus C. Okay, we are finding equation of AD. Look back at this AD. So this one, as I say, you don't simply see coordinate, you just sub in. You don't sub in B, you don't sub in C. But why do you sub in A? Because this A here, passing through this line. This line is passing through this A. Okay? So if you want to find equation of AD, you just need to sub in this one to find C. So point A, because point A is on the equation, on the line. So I sub in point A, 22, 18. So my C is 18 minus 11, 7. So equation of AD is Y equals to MX plus 7. Okay, so this is my equation of AD. This is confirmed my equation of AD. Why? Because the gradient is the same as this gradient. You double check again. This gradient is half. So this gradient is also half. Okay, double check again. You actually sub in the gradient half. And then you sub in the correct point, which is A, to your equation here. Okay, so double check. You are actually using the right coordinate. And you have a right gradient. Then your equation won't get wrong, unless you have careless mistake. Okay, that's for equation AD. Let's look at C. Equation of CD. CD ya mana? Sini. CD here. So y equals to mx plus c also. So y equals mx plus c, you need to find m. What is your m? M is not given. And you don't have another point for you to find y2 minus y1. But perpendicular here. Okay, or here. So we know that this gradient is your negative reciprocal of your gradient of BC. So this gradient will confirm is negative 2. So your gradient of DC or CD is negative 2. Okay, negative and reciprocal, huh? So it's negative 2. So part C, I'm finding equation of CD. So my gradient of CD is negative 2, negative reciprocal. And the point that I'm going to use is point C because it's passing through C. Okay, use the correct point. Double check again. You're using point C because this line passing through it. It doesn't pass through B, so don't use B. Doesn't pass through A, don't sub in A. Okay? So, like that. So, y equals to negative 2x plus c. I sub in this point. So, c is negative 3. Therefore, my y equals mx plus c is this. Okay? That's for my equation CD. D. Coordinate of D. Part D, they're asking for coordinate of D. Okay, so coordinate of D is a point of intersection, right? You see this point D is a point of intersection between this equation CD and AD. Do we have AD? We have CD? Yes. Normally this kind of question, after finding equation, they ask you to find coordinate. It's normally point of intersection. So you have these two points, which is your point of intersection to find D. Okay, so to find coordinate of D, which is your point of intersection, use simultaneous equation, these two. Okay, so this one is okay, and you sub in to y, any of the y also can. I sub in the one without fraction, is easier. So it's 5. So coordinate of D is negative 4, 5. Highlight answer. Now, part E. Area of the trapezium. So area of trapezium, as long as we have all the coordinates, then we can find. Okay, D we found it earlier. A we have, B we have, C we have. Okay, so when you do this kind of question, right, you must be very, very, very careful. You know why? Because if your part A wrong, imagine until part E, your area, you need your A correct. Then only you can find the correct area. Isn't it? And you need your A correct in order to find your equation of AD correct. Right? When your equation of AD is correct, then your equation of CD can be correct also. But if part A wrong, then all the way down all wrong. Okay? So please be very careful and check your working. Okay? Step by step. So part E, area of trapezium. Half. Okay, I'm gonna start with 22.8 and like that. Negative 7, 12, negative 2, and 22.18. Correct? Okay. Then I can do my area. So it equals to half. Okay, so look at my working here. Okay, it's very organized, isn't it? So make sure that you write your in a proper working here. Okay, so for today, I only teach question 19 and 20. Okay, but your work, okay, because you already copied the question 19 and 20 and already refer to my working here, right? Okay, so what I want you to do now is, okay, to check whether you got listen to my video, okay, then you have to follow my instruction, okay? So today's lesson 12, okay, from your textbook, right, which is your page 173, I only give question 19 and 20, right? Okay, so here we have another 19 and 20, which is exactly the same questions, okay? I want you to redo again. Okay, again two times, okay? Redo again two times. So the first time, I'm just going to write down like that only. Huh? Redo again, question 19 and 20. This time you use timer. Okay, organize your work or your working. Organize your workings properly. Redo using timer. Okay, write down. Please write down your duration. Must write down. Your duration, the time. Okay, for question 19 and also question 20, and please make sure your answer is correct. Meaning to say that you're gonna do this two times. Two times, times two. Okay, first time is when you refer to my lesson. And second time is after finish question 19 and 20 with referring my answer here. You do by your own one more time and see how long you need to do this question, these two questions, okay? Okay, so if you got listen to my instruction, then I will see four solutions, okay? First time you got copy the question. Second time, this time, you no need to copy question. No need to copy question, okay? Just make sure your answer is correct and please write down your timer, your time. All right? All right, that's all for today. Thank you guys. Bye.